kids to the circus. Now, the home of the greatest show on earth is paying a record fine for allegedly mistreating elephants. Take a look at this piece of video. This is undercover video. This is from PETA back in 2009. The animal rights group and myriad organizations have accused the circus of abusing and exploiting elephants using the metal hook. It's called a bull hook. So the parent company of Ringling Brothers and Barnum & Bailey Circus is paying out this $270,000 fine to the USDA for such violations.
For one reason, and one reason only. That reason is not to destroy the circus. It's not to free all elephants from captivity. The reason we've all come together is to protect endangered Asian elephants from the harm and abuse that they've been suffering for decades at the hands of Ringling Brothers and Feld.
Thank you. you think of the elephant when you think of a circus, what do these guys do?
Well, everything that we have them do here is based on natural abilities that they have during their playtime. And we, the trainers, get to make up the routine, so we see which elephants like to do things more and which ones are more natural show-offs. So they'll dance in the show, which is simple as them shaking the hay off their back. They'll waltz, which is turning. They'll lie down. They'll sit up. So, you know, it's everything that we see them do during their playtimes. We set it to cue, and after a while with treats and reward, you know, we have our routine made.
They start when they're five. It's the same thing with the elephants. They start when they're about so big. And they're like a dog then. You can, if you want the elephant to sit up, you just pick their little feet up and give them a banana, and it's just like training a dog to sit up. They...
Ringling's training facility that's all fenced in so nobody from the outside can see in. And rock and roll music plays loud so nobody can hear what's coming out of there.
Oh, just to cover up the elephant screaming?
Yes, ma'am. Two guys poking the baby elephant in the tender spots on top of its hind legs, and Gary's got the tender spot behind its head. So what's the elephant to do but stand on its head?
How many bullhooks are on an elephant right now?
Three. They're guide out to the bars behind these guys, so its hind legs can't move anyway but backwards. They're forcing the elephant backwards. The tub's slid up underneath it so it comfortably sits down. Has no alternative. Unless it wants to face a hot shot or a bull hook. Underneath it, and he pulls down with a hook on the top of its head like so in this picture, and the baby elephant is slammed to the ground. Those are basically the training techniques that Mr. Gary Jacobson uses. A lot of manpower and brute force, a little electricity, a little savage disposition. A baby elephant that's been pulled from its mother approximately 3 weeks, and it's first time it's been turned loose in 3 weeks, to just for a little walk around the barn to loosen its legs up.
So it's been chained up for 3 weeks straight?
Pretty much.
Okay, yeah. means to break their spirit. You can't control an elephant with a hook or a chain unless you first break their spirit. You chain them, you break them, you teach them that they depend on you for everything they need. The amount of suffering those elephants and the tigers and the lions, but the amount of suffering those elephants go through in order to entertain anyone's five-year-old for 15 minutes is a crime.
States.
The problems that I've seen documented with the elephants I've worked with these last 40 years, it is absolutely inappropriate for the American people to allow Ringling to continue traveling these animals and putting them in the conditions they put them in.